Welcome back to my new video in Learn Economia. It's actually the balanced growth approach of Rosenstein Rodan. For convenience, actually this particular topic is divided into three different videos. Part one of this particular topic would be discussed in this video, and I will be uploading part two and three very soon. Before starting the video, I would like to request you to like, share and subscribe this channel for more videos. And also I would like to request all my subscribers to click the bell icon, so as you will be able to get the notifications of regarding new videos as soon as I upload the new ones. So with that, we will be starting the balanced growth approach of Rosenstein Rodan. So the balanced growth approach of Rosenstein Rodan is actually considered to be a stringent variant of the theory of balanced growth. The main crux of this theory is that obstacles of development are actually formidable and pervasive. And this is something what we know. And it is also important to know that the development process by its very nature is not a smooth and uninterrupted process. In between development process, a country has to go through the path of discontinuity, jams, humps, and thus it's a path of discontinuity, interruptions, and unsmoothness. So the factors affecting economic growth, though functionally related with each other, are marked by a number of discontinuities and humps. There are chances that the economy can go through a slightly continuous and smooth development process. So for achieving this, a country has to go for one particular move. What is that move? So as per the big push approach, it is a big push that is a need of tower. A big push is something that is considered to undo the initial inertia of the stagnant economy. It is only then such a smooth journey of the economy towards higher levels of productivity and income can be assured. This is what is argued by Rosenstein Rodan in their big push approach. So as per him, unless big initial momentum is imparted to the economy, it would fail to achieve a self-generating and cumulative growth. He also argues that a certain minimum of initial speed is essential if at all the race is to be run. He has also highlighted the importance of the pace of such an investment, the size of such an investment, etc. Now, having understood what is the big push approach is all about, it's important to understand the rationale for big push. The basic rationale for big push is actually same for both big push theory and the balanced growth approach. So it is the main cruxes or the main underlying idea is external economies. In the theory of microeconomics or in the theory of welfare economics, external economies are defined as something that are unpaid benefits that go to the third party. So the private cost, prices, etc. of the products fail to reflect these external economies. And the market prices have to be corrected if an account of these external economies has to be taken into consideration. However, the concept of external economies has a different connotation in the case of growth theory. So, in the growth theory, these external economies are pecuniary in nature and get transmitted through the price system. So this underlying difference has to be understood. So in the microeconomic theory or in the welfare economics, there is this this external economies does not take into account the these are not considered in the pricing mechanism or in the calculation of cost, whereas in the case of development of growth economics, the monetary aspect of this external economies are considered. Now, so in order to understand this example very clearly in the with respect to growth economics or development economics, we can understand a situation. Here there are two industries, industry A and industry B, and are involved in this particular example. So consider a situation in which if industry A expands in order to overcome the technical indivisibilities, it shall derive certain internal economies. This may result in lowering the price for the product of industry A. Now, if the industry B uses industry A's output as an input, the benefits of industry A's internal economies shall then be passed on to industry B in the form of pecuniary external economies. Thus, profits of industry B created by lower prices of the product. A call for investment and expansion in industry B, one result of which will be an increase in industry B's demand for industry A's product. This is in turn will give rise to profits and recall and call for further investment and expansion of industry A. So here we can understand how the attempt to deal with technical indivisibilities by industry A make industry A to derive not only internal economies but also its further investment and expansion through the development of industry B. Now, following such a line of argument, Rosenstein Rodan contends the importance of external economies. So, in the theory of growth, external economies abound because given the inherent imperfections of investment market, imperfect knowledge and risk, pecuniary and technological external economies have a similarly disturbing effect on the path towards equilibrium. The basic contention of the big push theory is that such a mutually beneficial way of output expansion is not likely to occur unless the initial obstacles are overcome. Now, the initial obstacle here means the obstacle with respect to indivisibilities. Now, there are non-appropriabilities or indivisibilities of different kinds which, if not removed through a big push, will not permit the emergence or transmission of external economies, which are considered to lie at the back of the self-generating development process. Associated with the removal of each set of indivisibilities is a stream of external economies. So, as per Rosenstein Rodan, a bit-by-bit approach to development actually would not enable the economy to cross or overcome such indivisible economic obstacles to development. What required in this particular stage is a vigorous effort to jump over these obstacles. For the economy to be successfully launched on the path of self-generating growth, a big push in the form of minimum size of investment program is very much necessary. So Rosenstein Rodan actually was very much extreme to his argument, and he argued that either the economy can go for a nothing approach rather than creating a something approach to development, or it can go through an all approach, which is a big push approach, so as to attain the path of development in a very ensured manner and in a very improved and sustained manner. So with this, we are going to end this video. The more videos would be coming regarding what are the indivisibilities confronted by industries in an economy, and what are the requirements for big push, or why big push is required, many other aspects of big push theory or big push approach would be covered in my upcoming videos. So again, I would like to request you to like, share and subscribe my channel, and thank you for watching this video.